from aromatic compounds.
Okay, already from aromatic compounds, from toluene side chain chlorination followed by hydrolysis method is given. Already complete. The last one, by oxidation of toluene.
By oxidation of toluene. So based on oxidation of toluene, we prepared here particularly aldehydes. This reaction is also called ETARD reaction.
Generally in this process, so toluene and its derivatives are oxidized by strong oxidizing agents. If we can take toluene, see this
methyl benzene is called toluene. We know about this.
Now, if the toluene is oxidized by strong oxidizing agents, okay, if we can take strong oxidizing agents, toluene directly converted as a corresponding carboxylic acid, COOH. But we want aldehydes. If to stop the reaction at aldehydic stage, by using a special oxidizing agent like chromyl chloride, CrO2Cl2.
Chromyl chloride.
In the presence of carbon disulfide solvent, if the oxidation takes place in the presence of chromyl chloride, we get initially an intermediate complex compound. Okay, see this. In this process, so here CH, generally two hydrogens combines with here oxygen. So OCROH, see this, here CrO2 is there. I have taken OCROH. Okay, here the oxygen combined with hydrogens, remaining Cl2. Okay, how many? Two hydrogens. We get this intermediate compound. If it is on acid hydrolysis, H3O+. If this chromium complex acid hydrolysis, here the CH combines with the oxygen, we get CHO. It is called benzaldehyde. This reaction is called ETARD reaction. Here directly toluene is oxidized with chromyl chloride, we get benzaldehyde. It is called ETARD reaction. Otherwise, if and its derivatives, if I have taken toluene derivative like this, here I have taken just NO2 group, okay, 4-nitrotoluene, whatever that, say this, 4-nitrotoluene. Now this compound, if reacts with CH3CO, taken twice O, what is the name of this? It is called acetic anhydride. So in the presence of oxidizing agent chromium oxide, CrO3, by using CrO3 approximately 273 to 278 kelvins, this process also same there also here. O combined with hydrogen, we get OH, intermediate complex. See this, same. Here CH, OCOCH3, O combined with, see this. OCOCH3 taken twice. We get the type of intermediate complex. Okay, after that, remaining as it is. So now it is on acid hydrolysis. Acid hydrolysis. See this. S3O plus. Now we get here corresponding aldehyde. 4-nitrobenzaldehyde here we are getting. 4-nitrobenzaldehyde. This reaction is called generally Attard reaction. Toluene or its derivatives. Toluene or its derivative. So it is also called diacetyl derivative. What we can say? Diacetyl derivative. So based on all these process, we are prepared aldehydes and ketones. Now all preparations of aldehydes and ketones completed. Listen. So then aldehydes and ketones, physical properties. What are the physical properties of aldehydes and ketones? Okay, see, first write on that one. Then I will give physical properties. Okay. Let's see. Okay, if you are observed physical properties, so physical states and order. For example, here, if you can take aldehyde, first aldehyde, formaldehyde. So formaldehyde is a gas. Generally, physical state mein methanol, that is a exists as a gas. Methanol is a pungent smelling gas. Methanol. It is exists as a gas. Pungent smell means strong odor. So generally methanol, it is stored and used as. It is stored. And used as. So it is a gas. That's why it is stored and used as 40% aqueous solution. 40%. Aqueous solution. Aqueous solution means along with we can take the water. 40% aqueous solution known as formalin. Known as formalin. Okay, formalin means generally, so formalin. Formaldehyde at room temperature. Generally, it is exists as a gas. It is a pungent smelling gas. Pungent smelling means, okay, it is a strong odor. Okay, otherwise, see this. So, pungent smelling gas. It is a strong odor. It is stored and used as 40% aqueous solution along with water. We are stored. Okay, that is referred as a formalin. Okay, formaldehyde and water, that combination, that solution is called formalin. Generally remaining, if you can take ethanol and acetone, okay, it is nothing but, so acetaldehyde and acetone. So these are exist as a volatile liquids.
These are volatile. Volatile liquids.
So these are exist as a volatile liquids and other aldehydes and ketones up to 11 carbon atoms are colorless liquids. While others are remaining are solids. Generally up to 11 carbon atoms.
Liquids. And others are solids.
So here if you are observed, see this. So higher members of aldehydes and ketones are, if we can take higher members. So higher members of aldehydes and ketones are solids with fruity odor.
These are solids with fruity. Fruity odor.
So higher members of aldehydes and ketones are solids with fruity odor. Lower aldehydes having unpleasant odor. But ketones possess somewhat sweet odor. So finally, so formaldehyde, first one that is exist as a gas, remaining up to 11 carbons, these aldehydes and ketones are exist as a liquids, higher aldehydes and ketones are solids with somewhat fruity odor. Lower one, somewhat strong odor. Slow here. So almost, what about that? The molecular mass increase. These are somewhat sweet odor. Fruity odor means it is nothing but not strong, not pungent, not strong. This is look like a sweet odor. So now boiling points. If you can take boiling points here, particularly the boiling points of aldehydes and ketones. See this. Aldehydes and ketones having higher boiling points than hydrocarbons and ethers also. Okay, which have higher boiling points than corresponding hydrocarbons, alkanes, etc. And ethers also, comparable molecular masses. What is the meaning of that? Even though equal molecular mass case also, their aldehydes and ketones having higher boiling points because due to weak dipole-dipole interactions. Dipole-dipole means generally, so if you can take acetone-acetone between interactions are present. Dipole, two poles, partially positive pole, partially negative pole. At the same time, one more molecule, partially positive pole, partially negative pole. Dipole-dipole interactions. Because of that reason, which can show somewhat higher boiling points than hydrocarbons and ethers. But at the same time, their boiling points are lower than that of alcohols and carboxylic acids. Generally, comparable molecular mass, if you can take almost equal molecular mass of aldehyde and alcohol. So here alcohols having higher boiling points are present. So why? Because alcohols are formed. Alcohols and carboxylic acids are formed. So intermolecular hydrogen bond. But here aldehydes and ketones due to the absence of intermolecular hydrogen bond. Here reason due to the absence of intermolecular hydrogen bond. Here alcohols are formed, intermolecular hydrogen bond, Carboxylic acids also form intermolecular hydrogen bond. But aldehydes and ketones, there is no intermolecular hydrogen bond. Because of that reason, we can show lower boiling points compared to that. At the same time, if you can take isomeric aldehydes and ketones, ketones have slightly higher boiling points. For example, isomeric aldehydes and ketones. If you can take isomeric aldehydes and ketones, ketones having somewhat slightly higher boiling points than aldehydes. Compared to aldehydes, somewhat isomeric aldehydes and ketones means aldehydes and ketones are isomers. Isomers means same molecular mass. Same molecular mass means we are expected same boiling points. But here little bit, ketones having higher boiling points than aldehydes. Why? Because if you are observed ketones, with respect to ketone, right side and left side, two alkyl groups are present. So, due to the presence of two electron releasing alkyl groups, which makes carbonyl group more polar. Here we can say, due to the presence of two electron donating groups, alkyl groups, which makes, so here ketone, you can take any ketone with respect to carbon, left side alkyl group and right side alkyl groups are present. Because of that reason, which make carbonyl group more polar, What is the meaning of that? For example, say it is a carbonyl group. Here ketone, alkyl group. It is an electron donating group. It is also electron donating groups. So these electron donating groups increases the polarity of carbonyl carbon. This one, this polarity, charge somewhat increase. Because of that reason, little bit, ketones are slightly higher boiling points than aldehydes. Okay, the last one, if you can take solubility. See this? Physical properties mein solubility. Now, okay, solubility. Lower members of aldehydes and ketones, up to 4 carbon atoms are soluble in water due to hydrogen bonding between polar carbonyl group and water molecule. Generally, lower members. See? Brackets mein up to 4 carbons soluble in water due to the formation of hydrogen bond with water. See this, if you can take carbonyl compounds, aldehydes and ketones, it is nothing but aldehyde and ketone. Now, it is a partially positive charge, partially negative charge. If you can take water, it is a carbonyl group, maybe aldehyde or ketone, maybe aldehyde or ketone. See?
So water H2O. Now between carbonyl group and water, here we are observed force of attractions. It is called intermolecular hydrogen bond. So because of this intermolecular hydrogen bond, up to four carbons, aldehydes and ketones, up to four carbons, aldehydes and ketones low. These are highly soluble in water. Between carbonyl compound, it is maybe ester aldehyde, ethanol, propanol, butanol, whatever that. Okay, propanone, butanone, like that. Up to four carbons, highly soluble in water. It is the formation of intermolecular hydrogen bond with water. But we know that number of carbons increase, the solubility, what about that, decrease. Along with molecular weight increase, I have given the hydrophobic alkyl group size increase, solubility decrease. So see, along with molecular mass, otherwise number of carbons increases, solubility decreases. Solubility decreases along with molecular mass. Number of carbons increases, solubility decreases. So here one more, say if aromatic aldehydes and ketones are much less soluble than corresponding aliphatic aldehydes and ketones. Generally, aromatic, because larger benzene ring is there, number of carbons are automatically more. Aromatic aldehydes and ketones, matlab C. Aromatic aldehydes and ketones having generally what I have given, lesser soluble. Lesser soluble than aliphatic. Aliphatic aldehydes and ketones, aromatic aldehydes and ketones having lesser solubility than aliphatic aldehydes and ketones because due to big size, larger benzene ring. Otherwise, due to larger benzene ring. All carbonyl compounds are generally fairly soluble in organic solvents. Okay, somewhat soluble. Organic compounds are soluble in organic solvents. See, all carbonyl compounds are fairly soluble in organic solvents. Okay, write down these are.
write down. Okay, screen clear now. कंप्लीट कर लो बेटा. ओके, फिजिकल प्रॉपर्टीज कंप्लीट करो. Okay, completed now. Okay, see now aldehydes and ketones. So preparations and physical properties are completed. So here main physical properties means just the lower aldehydes and ketones are liquids mostly. Only the formaldehyde it exists as a gas. Remaining are mostly up to 11, 12 carbons. These are liquids. Remaining are solids. So second thing, boiling points. Boiling points wise, aldehydes and ketones having somewhat higher boiling points than hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons nothing but alkanes, alkenes, alkynes, even though aromatic compounds, benzene and ethers also. Why? Because which contain aldehydes and ketones, dipole-dipole interactions. So because of that reason it can show the higher boiling points. Now compared to alcohols and carboxylic acids which have lower boiling points. Why? Because alcohols are form hydrogen bond, acids also form hydrogen bond, but aldehydes and ketones does not form hydrogen bond. Because of that reason which can show lower boiling points compared to alcohols and acids. Next, solubility. Generally lower members up to 4 carbons, these are soluble in water. Why? Because which can form intermolecular hydrogen bond with water. Okay, along with the number of carbons, as a molecular mass increase, the solubilities are decrease. Okay, then aromatic aldehydes